Dear colleagues from the media, thank you for coming once more to this briefing at the European Union Secretariat. I have just two issues that I want to speak to. Number one, the nation will recall that 2 days ago, I made a statement that I wasn't going to recontest the Choma Central seat for which I have been a member of parliament for the last 10 years. That statement has sparked very huge political media firestorm, and I think we all agree. People have received that announcement differently. People have accepted my decision. Others have rejected my decision. I have since have had no peace whatsoever. My phone rings every day. The only other phone I think which has been, every minute. My phone had become a switchboard. The only time it wasn't ringing was when it was off. And people have taken advantage of that statement to describe me. Some have said that I wasn't contesting because I have lost ground in Choma. Far from it. Others have said I have been bought by PF. How can I be bought by PF when rejected to be bought over Butte? Others have seen on PF, run media, speculation. No, he's being reserved for running me for HH. We don't work like that in the UPND. If you check, have a checklist, look at our NMC, you will find the national representation. Ask PF, look at their cabinet, their PSAs, and let them tell you who those ministers and the PSAs and the people they are appointing. No national representation. That is one of the things you want to cure when you form the next cabinet. Others have even stated that I am not contesting because I have no great hopes of it. So many names. I'm tired. I thought I needed to come back and clarify my position, the people. And wish to report that I have since received petitions from chiefs, not just of Choma or Southern Province, in this country. I have received petitions from UPND members across the country. You saw yesterday, people were thinking I'm at my home in Choma. They went there, headmen, members of a party, especially youth, even giving me an ultimatum to rescind my decision. I received calls from the diaspora, colleagues who we have been waging a war on corruption with. Spoke to me. The women movement spoke to me because in parliament I'm the chairperson for the men's network on gender equality. Civil servants at large, because as a former police officer, when I'm in parliament, I speak for police. And as a former teacher, when I'm in parliament, I speak for teachers. And as a lawyer, when I'm in parliament, I speak for lawyers. And as a politician, I speak for all Zambians in that parliament. Young politicians who want to aspire to become councillors, mayors, and members of parliament petitioned me. I have since received wise counsel from senior citizens, statesmen who summoned me, like VJ Venon Mwanga, he summoned me. People like Honorable Norman Chibamba, the former MP for Shiwangani, he summoned me and sat me down to explain what necessitated the disease, what was the stimulus. And I think that I had made it very clear that the reason I wanted to step aside was because I wanted to be at the center campaigning for HH. Honorable Chibamba and VJ, among other people who are well versed in politics and experienced, put one statement which affected me very clearly. And this statement appears to be resonating with everyone who has petitioned me. They have said, we need people who can hold their ground in Parliament. And they said, you are one of them, just like Honorable Nkombo, among others. And have made one very important issue or observation, which I have agreed with them, because I've been left with no option. They are saying you cannot leave Parliament at a time which is forming government. And because of the reasons that people have given, and I've also understood that one of the things that makes the work of a member of Parliament difficult when you're in the opposition is because people expect you to deliver development when in fact you can't, when you are under a government like PF. HH has told this nation that when he becomes president, CDF, I think Honorable Nkombo, HH has said CDF will be 5 million per constituency, isn't it? If my memory is right. So therefore, now that HH is winning, CDF will be $5 million. It will be easier for one to be a member of Parliament. And I believe this is not just going to advantage members of Parliament of the UPND across, because we do not expect that we should have only UPND members of Parliament across the country. That can give democracy. You need opposition so that they are able to advise you where they feel you are not doing what is right. I therefore have come to state that I have today, Tuesday, here at the party secretariat, due to public pressure, rescinded my decision not to contest. And my campaign machinery will roll into Choma very soon. But again, people have told me, don't worry about campaigning here, the campaign is over. You will continue with HH, here you have already won. So I agree with the people. People have also maintained that this is not time to change MPs anyhow. Yes. They have said where you must change an MP now in UPND, there must be a compelling reason. Yeah. Not personal reasons like yes. The one
yes.
I had.
Yeah. Yes.
Compelling reasons. Because HH and UPND, through the UPNDC alliance, are forming the next government. So I wish to end this speculation where people have been calling me all sorts of names. And also take advantage to thank everyone who expressed their views. I've learned a lot. I also want to thank my colleagues in the PF, some ministers, members of parliament, who took time to make a phone call and rejected my decision. I think this is the way it should be. That when we differ politically on ideology, we still have the interest of the nation together. I'm left with no choice but to bow to public pressure. So please spare my phone now. I do other things. I want now to continue campaigning for it in the manner I wanted, given that the people of Choma have told me that there will be no need for me to campaign there. So those who are giving me ultimatum, I have bowed to your ultimatum. Because when you are a leader, you must do what people want, not what you want.
Yes.
And it is our tradition as UPND to listen to the people. That is why in 2016, when the people said they don't want the referendum to tamper with the Bill of Rights, we went flat out and we defeated PF. The people said, no, we don't want Zambia to be removed from the International Criminal Court. Again, we campaigned and defeated PF on that referendum. The people said, we don't want butane. We rejected their money and butane collapsed against all odds and against their money. People have said they don't want the cyber security law. HH has committed to come and review that, repeal it. Leadership should be people demand driven, not what you want. I hope I have clarified that position, because this has really haunted me the last 2 days. People have said, look, where we are now, it's like a national team has qualified to the World Cup, and then you want to go and play the World Cup final. Then some senior players started, you know, quitting the national team. You demoralize the supporters. So I don't want to demoralize anyone. I will run for the Choma seat, and hopefully, no one should change and begin to ask me to go and campaign when they told me that they don't need me to campaign there.